So I'm Leah Dosanjh, I'm an audiologist, and today we're going to go over what a listening check is, why we do it, and how to do it. So a listening check is something that we do on hearing aids in order to ensure that they're appropriately functioning. So we want to make sure that the volume is correct for the patient, that there's no feedback, that there's no distortion, and that there isn't generally something wrong with the hearing aid before the patient starts to wear them. So generally, the school team will have somebody designated to do a listening check at the start of the day before the patient has to start participating in school, so that way their equipment is functioning the way it is supposed to. And it needs to be done daily and generally first thing in the morning. And we are going to perform a listening check on a BTE, that's a behind-the-ear hearing aid, with a battery door. So the very first thing that you want to have handy is a listener. This is just one example of what they can look like. But generally what you'll have is a piece that goes down inside your ears and a piece that connects to the hearing aid itself so that you can hear the output of the hearing aid. So you'll put the listening end into your ears. And then you will take the end of it and put the ear mold down with a nice seal into the base of your listening tube. So what you want to do with this is to use some common sounds. I like to use either the Ling 6 sounds or generally vowels and consonant sounds so that I can get a good sweep of what the hearing aid output is doing with different sounds. So if any of those sounds don't sound right, if they sound distorted or if there's any kind of feedback, that's a sign to check to see if there's something blocking the ear mold. But if everything sounds fine, you also want to check. You'll remove the tubing from the tone hook. And then you'll place the tone hook tip down into the tubing part of the listener. And then you'll use those same exact sounds. To check to see if there's any distortion coming from the tone hook. It's nice to do a bottom-up approach, essentially trying each piece out with the hearing aid so that you can decipher where the problem is. So then the next thing that you'll want to check is to remove the tone hook. Most of them twist off, but some of them just pull out. And then you're going to do that same listening check over the tip here. And by taking apart each piece systematically, you can find out where the problem is, if there is one. But hopefully there is no problem and everything sounds great all the way through. There. The next thing that you want to do is check for there to be corrosion down inside the battery door here. And if you do find any kind of debris or corrosion inside the battery door, you want to clean it out with a microfiber cloth. If it's really stuck in there, then have the patient go to their audiologist so that they can clean out that device.